I'm at one of the tallest wind farms in Europe. Look at that, isn't that beautiful? You can't tell right now, but basically when the cloud goes over, that is so high that it casts a shadow on the cloud as it's passing by. But the reason I'm here is because of something you might not know, which is why, when it's windy, wind farms aren't always on and rotating. And there are a couple of reasons. One is that wind farms aren't built to take extremely high wind speeds. Above 50, 55 miles an hour, it starts to get dangerous, and this beautiful thing could rip itself apart. So, at high winds, they slam the brakes on and they stop them running, because the amount of energy you would lose from doing that is much less than the amount of energy you would constantly lose if you had to build this thing to withstand hurricane force winds. The other reason is that the national grid can't cope with more than enough power being dumped into it. There are no giant storage batteries that can hold the entire output of a power station. So, what happens is, if the demand is low, then they will just turn off the ones that are easy to turn off, like this. And when demand rises again, they will turn on this and hydroelectric power plants in order to deal with instant demand. Nuclear, coal, gas, all much harder to shut down, all much harder to start up. And so, the national grid keeps us balanced at 50 hertz, 50 cycles a second, 60 in America, 50 in Britain, by monitoring the plants like this and turning them up and off as needs be. And that is something you might not have known.